Greetings, I, the War Owl, greets you, and I'm going to be showing you here once again another 5v5 Counter-Strike Global Offensive match, and this one is going to be from the Inferno Online Pantamera Challenge, and this is going to be between LGB, newly reformed LGB, with the Norwegian folks from London Conspiracy, taking on the long-standing top Polish team in the world, Virtus.pro. And it looks like Virtus.pro is going to be boosting a few players up here, trying to work on some kind of an A-split, it seems. Three players up in wait there. That's actually really interesting. We have two players on the CT side sitting inside of the site. Players middle now deciding to push in. Keep in mind, Virtus.pro is a very strong team on this map in particular. Look at that, Taz going after Rubino in the smoke there. We have a good rotate from CTs. Oh, Pasha sneaks up from behind and grabs a two frag. Now just a few players left inside of the site. Just Rubino. Got to hold off the entire army here, and this player, Jacob, 1v4. Nice shot on Pasha, but that's probably all he's going to be able to get here. And Yan takes a little bit of a flash. Sort of a half flash on him. All he can really hope for now is to get some exit frags. I mean, 1v3. Yeah, I don't think so. He actually only has one magazine left in this USP. He's going to have to drop it and get another one. Don't worry, Neo drops him first, and Virtus.pro will take the pistol round here. Now, LGB, the Norwegian team, not really a team I'm too familiar with. This player, Jikim, and Zeeves are two players I have not seen very often. We see some of these players are from the old London Conspiracy. Oh, look at this. Second round buy here from Snacks is going to be a sawed-off shotgun. Now, that's a real unique weapon to see ever purchased, because shotguns on T-side are usually not very useful. Snacks, if a player was going to purchase one of these, this would be the player. We remember his excellent Nova Ace on Train back in Yielded Days. He actually got an ace with this thing, or with a different shotgun. Now, this will really help him a lot in clearing out checkers. He flashes out Polly. Polly gonna be rotating back into the site. And yeah, I don't think this is gonna be too useful now. Looks like T's are rotating back to take bomb site B, and yeah, even at this distance, he knows he has to pull out the Glock. It's not the weapon that he wants. Look at this, USP player is able to push back a Glock player. T's move in and take the site, and check this out, LGB expecting it, or not really expecting, but just sort of doing an armor pistol by rock, paper, scissors game, flipped a coin, said we're going to position all our guys over here at A, and Virtus.pro, very intelligently, sort of whittled their way around the map and kind of figure out what was going on, and then finally pushed into bombsite B where they felt safe, and I think it may have been Snacks scouting that out, seeing Polly and running into checkers like that, that gave Virtus.pro that intel and allowed them to confidently push into the site. So, looking like LGB is going to save the next round, and this is going to be an interesting round because you don't really usually expect to see this many players survive. They've got A site as like a stronghold right now as the T players move out and search for them, trying to find them hiding. And I say it's going to be an interesting round because this is a round where you should have a saving team. Or rather, not purchase anything. However, LGB, because of that rock-paper-scissorness there, which is actually really smart, because they'll have another chance at an armor pistol here and will still be able to buy up on round number 4, no matter what happens on this round. So that's an interesting strategy. Just save all of your players. Say, let's put everybody inside of A site, and if it fails, it fails. But we can still go for it a second time. Let's say it's 50-50, which side the teams do go on. That's good enough to probably try that. I actually have not seen that yet. All right, LGB just lost their player inside of A, and it looks like Virtus.pro is creeping up on it. Here is Rain waiting for these players to come through the highway here. And he's got good vision of it. Those players are going to sneak right by him, though. We see Zeeves trying to sneak up from behind right here. Pasha watching it. And I don't think they're going to be able to make anything happen here. Notice that Snacks is still holding on to that sawed-off. Lurk player Snacks actually just went down. He was trying to hunt down Zeeves here, but he was able to pick him. And it looks like, once again, will LGB save? Will actually pick up the sawed-off? I don't know how useful that's going to be, Polly. And Neo seems to be hunting them down right now, out lurking the lurks. And player's right around the corner there. He's going to check the site. Will he find this player? He's actually at mid right now. Sneaks by him. Rain had a chance to hit that player. Oh! Had a huge chance to kill some players there. Pasha now moving in for the kill. Bomb will go off. Let's see if they can pick up rain here at the end. Looks like Taz wants to charge him a little bit. Nope, not gonna happen. No blood spilled. All right, that's the first 3 points for Virtus.pro. LGB will be able to buy up this round as well. They saved a lot. They didn't die a lot. And another thing saving like that accomplishes is it doesn't give Virtus.pro that extra economy that they would have gotten by killing those players. It's 300 a player, and if Snack's got to kill 900. All right. T's going to be splitting up across the map, playing it safe. I don't know. Freiburg joined the game somehow. That's a little bit weird. Okay. Rubino in a forward position. He'll get good intel here about what's going on. Here's the player going into A main. Should call for one of these players to rotate and help him out. Polly probably should go to truck right now based on the intel. Doesn't look like that's going to happen, though. They just have one player inside of A right now. Virtus.pro playing it safe, feeling it out. Snacks has got the AWP. Going to be aggressive AWPing over here at bombsite B. They're leaving Jacob here. Notice they've switched up their position already here. We have Polly starting to AWP at middle, who was previously playing inside of bombsite B. Of course, you can switch the AWP around. And they're moving that bomb now to go over to A side. We see them setting up for it. This is an interesting Molotov to take out the vents. That's a common spot for players to sit. Now, Rubino at middle just picked off Pasha and Neo. Nice job. And it looks like Bialy is trying to entry frag into bombsite A. In the meantime, though, it is a trap. Bialy is just a distraction as the T's move in here. Take bombsite B. Nice entry kill by Taz. Bialy, in the meantime, is holding these players here, not allowing them to rotate. It's all up to Rubino now. He's got to get an ace to win it. Takes out Snacks. Actually, this is really good. If he can pick off Taz... Well, never mind. Taz holds it off and kills Rubino. And I was saying, because of the positioning of Bialy, if he could kill off Taz, he could actually defuse that bomb before Bialy had a chance to rotate all the way over from A. And he had intel of that. All right. Virtus.pro now at 4 points, leading LGB. That was their chance to get back into this game economically. Now they're going to have to wait another 2 rounds. And pre-flash is going off. T's going to be working on this mid control. Here comes Neo out. Very aggressively going into the vents. It doesn't look like they're actually deciding to push here. We actually had a team block. They don't know about Zeeves. Oh, Neo could get caught off guard. And he does, but it's a trade. Don't worry. Pasha picks it up. Trying to hide those weapons. Failed miserably, but that's okay. We still love you, Pasha. You have biceps. Pasha pushing into bombsite B. Seems like everything can be forgiven, no matter what Pasha does. He has biceps after all. Another pistol pickup there. Rubino doing a brilliant job. Snacks trades it, but 2-for-1 sale over here at bombsite B. It looks bleak. No scope by Snacks with that man of war. And Taz picks up the final kill. Looked like LGB had a chance to win an eco there. That was a nice attempt. Both of those players still alive on Virtus.pro were very low to death. All right, they are able to afford an AWP here for Polly. Let's see if Polly continues to play middle. Oh, look at this. They're going to be doing a double AWP strategy with Rain. Rain going to be playing A, and then Polly at middle. Not going to be doing the AWP B, which is something we see very commonly on Cash. Again, keep in mind, Virtus.pro, very strong team on Cash. More experienced team overall. Definitely going to be favored in this. Now, I like Rubino's positioning here at middle. Stands very close to the smoke there. They seem to know that this player is consistently playing at middle. They throw another Molotov there. Looking like Snacks is going for a pick. He does get it, but he doesn't know if the player hiding back there. Bialy is setting up for his entry frags right here. Pasha gonna peek middle as soon as he smokes clear. Looking like T's are gonna be away. They got the bomb dropped. Oh my gosh. We actually have a trade over there by Snacks. Oh no. Polly picks off Pasha. And now it looks like this could be a round for LGB. Rain takes a flash here inside of the site. Just misses Neo. Polly moves in at the same time. Two AWPers in close range positions, taking on Virtus.pro players on Cash. And it's just Polly left here. Gonna be rotating Jackum back around the side. Picks off Taz. It's gonna be Neo. 1v2 now. Difficult holdoff. Got bomb planted in that standard safe position. There's one. Now just gonna be Polly. Knows the player's quad. Just misses it, and Neo picks up the kill. That's a 2-frag for the win. 1v2. Holding off the bomb. Virtus.pro now at 6 points, absolutely dominating LGB, which unfortunately is probably the expected outcome. Sorry to all you London conspiracy fans. Neo, with the AWP, going for a forward aggressive pick here. Kind of interesting to see Neo with an AWP doing this kind of a play, like a JW pick. It's not going to happen, though. Jackham saw what was going on. I don't think he's going to peek again. That would be unwise. Well, that's why it would be unwise. He does go down. Rubino inside of the vents. Rubino been playing a great game so far. Picking off some critical frags. Has not been enough yet to get a point for his team. Snacks get caught off guard. There's another two kill from Rubino. Two for one sale. Putting his team in a position to win it. The rest of the team just has to come through for the finish. Now it's Bialy. One versus three. Difficult situation. Has Polly inside of checkers. Looking like he's got enough time to go all the way back over to A. CT's got to know this. They have to keep one player in position there. That's going to be Rain. Bialy creeping forward at middle. Thinks the player might be trying to flank him right now. Which would be the other decision for Rain to do. To creep forward at middle and try and pick that player. Get in a sneaky position to catch them on the rotate. Instead, Rain's just going to be sitting inside of the site. Not worrying about the rotate at all. Could have kept eyes. Could have kept a track on Bialy here. Who's creeping into the site. Rain could catch him way off guard. Oh, Bialy picks off Rain with a nicely placed headshot. Bialy is the expert entry fragger there. Zeeves and Polly moving in to make it happen. Just one player left. That's Bialy. They trade it. Put those two players right by each other in order to ensure victory. So LGB finally picks up their first point here. Thanks to that nice trade at the end. Good teamwork there from LGB. They work together for that one. All right. Economic game. Virtus.pro well ahead after winning six rounds in a row. After not losing too many players. They have a ton of money right now. And they actually, if they lose this, might be able to do a buy next round as well. Ah, no, maybe not. They just have two players with enough money. LGB will be buying. We also see Jacob with a liberated AK-47. Looking like he's going to be playing the middle position this time. He plays inside of the vents. He's probably going to eat a Molotov. As we've seen, consistent Molotoving. Looks like they're sneaking up a player into the sneaky spot inside of A right here. And then falling back. Did Virtus.pro get intel about that? We saw them pre-shooting that position. They may actually know that they boosted a player up there. In which case, knowing about the player there makes the spot kind of useless. Bialy creeping forward. We see Rain right above him there on the left. Let's see if he can figure it out. Jakob at the middle position. Here's the footsteps. Knows what's going on. Pasha trying to push out middle. Not going to happen. Polly with a pre-shooting. And here's Rain. Sees Bialy's feet. Gives his position away, but he is able to pick off the player. Nice kill by Jakob at middle. Looks like a last-ditch effort to push into bombsite B. It's going to be successful. Oh no. Jakob moves through and catches both the players off guard. A nice three frag for this player. Against Virtus.pro. So that's 2 points now. Two in a row. And it looks like Virtus.pro has the decision of, we can do a buy, but it won't be a good buy. And yeah, they're going to be doing a buy, so two of those players are probably going to armor. Oh no, they could afford an extra AK. They got enough. They got enough. Just Snacks is rifle-less. They had to rifle through their wallet there, their collective wallet, to afford those weapons. Alright, looking like they're just planning an A take. Rain in position. T's charging forward. Nice pickup by Rain. Player sneaks up from behind him. Here is Polly now at quad. T's move in from all sides. Oh, Polly picks up that player. They're still moving into the site. One up top. Sees it. Picks it off with an excellent headshot. Here's Rubino from above. Two players, both of them. At the forklift, another nice pickup. Now just Snacks left. Rubino jumps in from above and gets another two frag. We've seen that a lot from Rubino, killing two players very close to each other. LGB now, 3 points, catching up to Virtus.pro, and Virtus.pro, that'll actually force them into a save. So they had to win three rounds in a row to finally force Virtus.pro to save this thing. And even then, they're still able to purchase a few pistols. So LGB's definitely back in this game. Cash is going to be a slightly CT-sided map. Sort of the same sidedness that you have on Inferno, for example. So LGB at this point should probably be sitting at 7 points and not 3. With Virtus.pro at 6. So they are behind. They do have to play a catch-up due to an early lead out of the gate by Virtus.pro. Now they're doing this thing, this pistol strat, once again, where they boost these players up here. I think they fell down a little bit. Last time they had 3 players up here. And then they do this split A to take that mid control. Rubino should be the player to take out these players jumping over the top there. And we see Pasha watching for a retake, or a rotate, for them to push from behind him there. T's getting ready to push into bombsite A. They've already pushed forward at middle. Ooh, Rubino gets picked by Pasha. This is actually a chance for Virtus.pro to take the site. Snack sneaks around, actually kills the player, wow. Oh, and they've also, in the meantime, rotated that bomb over here. It's a trap, it's a distraction, and Pasha's gonna try to plant it at bombsite B, but jack him right around the corner. Or Jakem, I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Please help. What? What? Pasha just walked right by him. He could have seen him. If he just turned, he would have seen him right there. 17 seconds left. Player still inside of quad, or inside of checkers. He's going to have to make a sound. And Pasha, what was Pasha doing? He could have walked into the site, gotten that bomb planted for the extra money. That was a curious play from Pasha. I think Pasha was assuming, all right, there's got to be a player that they left behind. I'm going to hunt him down. But I assure you, those two players were in full vision of each other. All they had to do was turn, and they walked right by each other. Very strange. Rubino taking a forward position once again. A little cheeky bunny hop to get in there. T's looking like they were going to do an A split. They have the bomb dropped just in case it's pop. Okay, there, Rain. I guess we'll shoot right at the player through the wall. That's okay. And T's getting ready to push into bombsite A right now. Once that A main smoke is... Oh, they got a boost? Yes, I always love this. I always love this boost. It looks like Neo is watching it. No, he's not. He turns at just the wrong time. They grab it and then fall back. That's very smart. But now it's up to Rain to hold off the site. Should throw that Molotov down. Polly gets the pick off of Taz. Another win here for LGB, more than likely, as the T's are going to have some trouble pushing into the site. Polly gets taken down. Went up top into the rafters. And here is Rubino now, who's rotated over to help out. Gets taken down. Rain is still up. Got to count on that entry frag by Bialy to get into the site. Nice spray down. CT's rotated into position. One player left. That is going to be Snacks. 1v3. Picks off Rain. Should try to go for a fake bomb plant right now to force these players out. Oh, pushes through the Molotov aggressively to try to pick this player. Doesn't know about Jakum right there. Look at this player. Such a lurk. Jakum sitting at the highway just out of view. And Zeeves is able to take that kill off of Snacks. And there's the defuse. LGB now with 5 points in a row, catching up to Virtus.pro. This is looking like it's going to be a very good game. And honestly, I wouldn't have picked it to cast if it wasn't, because this is a best of one. Virtus.pro still able to buy. LGB here, Polly with the AWP. Looking like now they're putting Polly over at B. We'll see if he jumps over the top and does a forward B. Yeah, okay, I love this positioning. It's a strong positioning. They got Jakum up here at the front. And looking like they want to take bombsite A here. This Molotov will be... Well, I was going to say will be successful, but it missed just by a little bit there. T's trying to work on that mid control. Creeping out forward at middle. Taz going for a pick. Neo takes the forward position. Going to peek over here on Zeeves pretty soon. Catches him jumping away, but some nice bunny hopping skills allows him to escape unscathed. T's now pushing at highway. Good pickup by Zeeves. Rain waiting for Bialy. And again, a nice attempt at a bombsite A split, but it's not going to work out for Virtus.pro. Seems like LGB has really figured out how to defend against Virtus.pro. I guess once they caught up economically, they're able to hold them off. And it looks like that's going to force Virtus.pro into another save here, unless they're feeling adventurous. Nope, looks like Virtus.pro, their economy has taken an arrow to the knee, and that's all the adventuring they're going to be doing. Polly back with the forward position at B. was not able to use it before, could get the pick off of Snacks. Now, we've seen Virtus.pro do this a few times so far. They stick Snacks by himself over B-side. Look at this stack by LGB. We got Zeeves, we got Jockum there, we got Polly. All these players were over at B-side, and in fact, the bomb was set up to go at B. Now they've rotated back a little bit. We see LGB spreading out a little bit more. Bomb coming back over here to B. Has been thrown over to Pasha, who's gonna try to solo it. When they have a player moving here solo, it's generally been Pasha. Looks like Neo's gonna come back him up. And Zeeves, the player in position to hold this off. Strong A hold by LGB. Whatever intel they got, to them they're saying, yeah, they're probably gonna be taking A. They set up for B early on, now they're setting up for A. Zeeves needs to hold off an entire army here and an army of pistolers. Oh my goodness, with that, Virtus.pro has a chance of taking this eco round. Jockum sneaks into the side, not gonna happen. Trying to throw those nades in there. Oh, the smokes! They need to start pushing through here fairly soon. There's no re-smokes for Virtus.pro, so as soon as they clear, they're gonna push into the site. There's the flash. Here comes the retake. 3v3 against these saving players. Two of them do have armor. And when are they gonna move? They need to move right now to get into that site. And they all get taken down in just a moment, and there is the defuse by Rubino. LGB wins it and just took the lead. That's 7 points in a row from LGB against Virtus.pro on cash. That is very good. It cannot be understated how well they're playing right now. A little bit of a confusing buy. I saw weapons flying back and forth trying to figure it out. Looked like they had the AWP over there, like they were going to throw it to Rain and do a double AWP, but decided not to do that at the last second, even though they have money for it. Nice pickup by Pasha. They got the AWP over on Pasha now instead of Neo. Pasha generally going to be the AWPer for Virtus.pro in those kinds of situations. Well, there's the pick at B. Nobody's at B right now. Virtus.pro surprisingly not pushing directly into the site. Looking like they've, oh, that is it. They've caused a rotate here, and instead they're going to play it safe. Focus on that mid control. 5v3 should be an easy pickup as long as they play their cards right. And walking forward very cautiously here. Just one player inside of bomb site A to deal with this. They're rotating back Polly, I think, to watch middle. It's too late, though. T's have taken control. They just picked off Rain. They're going to have it fairly soon. Polly, in a last-ditch effort to prevent the bomb from getting planted. Definitely not going to happen. Looks like they're hunting down Polly right now. And there he goes. Snacks finishes him off. 7-7 now. One round left in the half. It's all tied up. LGB needs to pick this thing up to put themselves at sort of an even score against Virtus.pro and give themselves a chance of winning this thing over on the T side. All right, let's see where they put Pasha now. Going to be opping T-side. Probably boost up so that he can watch middle. Most definitely. Notice they've been doing two players at mid. See Polly there. Oh, Polly takes the pick. We have a pick also over here at bomb site B. That's two picks. Puts it into a 5v3. We saw that happen on last round as well. When you get into a 5v3, it's almost like a, yep, we won. Picks like that, very important. And these picks have been happening really quickly. Rain about to fall from the sky here. Came down hard. All right. Oh, there's the Molotov to prevent Taz from helping out his team as they try to do. This A take. Counter Molotov's going down. Another one from Rain. They've got enough money. Why not? Rubino dodges that flash with finesse. And perfect position to mow them down there at quad. Takes out two of them, pulls out the pistol, and even wanted another one. Another two frag from Rubino, and that's going to end the half right there. 8-7, all tied up. Couldn't be closer at this point. I would just like to point out the very nice, old-school, matching avatars for LGB. Look at that. One color a player. Lines up pretty like, interesting attempt at it there from Virtus.pro. I always admire, a good regimen, or I don't know what you would call it. It's just classy. I like matching avatars. All right, decorum was the word I was thinking of. I don't know why I said regimen. All right, Pasha's in some trouble. He's got the whole team bearing down on him. Well, he is able to trade, and that is pretty much all you could hope for in a situation like that, where you get caught way off guard, and you're just like, yep, I'm dead. He went for a pick there. I guess he got his pick, but at what cost? The cost of his life. T's gonna be working on mid control right now. Took that opportunity to take great map positioning. They can go to any site they want right now. Looking like Virtus.pro thought it was gonna be an A take and started to rotate over to that side. The bomb is set up at A main right now, so it is going to be an A take, but it looks like LGB was trying to make it seem like it was gonna be a B take. By Rubino, he should break out this vent right here. Oh, they're rotating the bomb back. It is actually going to be a B take. So they finally decided on that. They've got one player to deal with. Neo in an abnormal position. Let's see if they can figure this out. All right, they're going to be moving through into checkers fairly sure. Oh, they don't know. They don't know. Neo takes out Polly and trades for him. Now, sometimes in a position like that, you let the player go by, if you know what I mean. You just let the player sneak by so you can pick up the second one, then kill the first one. Neo opting to just kill the bomb plant, or bomb carrier. 3v3 of the retake now in this all-important pistol round. Here comes Snack sneaking in from the back. Rubino takes it. If we know Rubino, he's going to kill one more player this round. No, it's not going to happen. Raiden picks up Bialy. One kill apiece for these three guys at the end. In a 3v3. LGB just won the pistol round. That's going to put them in the lead here. We should see the armor pistol buy from Virtus.pro. This is a double scout one is unique. Virtus.pro does that a lot since they have these two players capable of using these scoped weapons. Sometimes they'll actually give a scout to Snacks. Looking like it's just going to be an A tank right here. I think LGB is set up to take this. Well, actually, they just missed their opportunity. Pasha moves back into position. Bialy in a close position as well. Taz takes a pick. Oh, this is a disaster for LGB. They're able to sneak around Rubino at middle and get good positioning here. But really, that's it. It puts it into a one versus three now. Oh, what looked like it was going to be a great round for LGB turned into a complete disaster. 1 minute left. Rubino going to have to pull off some thrilling heroics. He just picks off Neo. Snacks the last player who is hiding inside of A main right now. And Rubino, not sure why he's in bomb site B. The bomb is down A main. Rotating all the way around. He thought the player was at the truck. That's interesting. He's wasting way too much time here in this 1v1. And there we are, 35 second mark. Checking every little position right now. Has no idea where Snacks is, and Snacks is just in wait right now. Able to climb his way solo up onto this box in preparations. And I think Snacks will probably have the upper hand here because you don't really expect to see a player up here. 15 seconds right now and Rubino is going to be forced to push. And I think Snacks should pick it up. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. All that preparation, all that tension, all that buildup for an anticlimactic boom, you got shot, you die. LGB just lost that second round. It just got stolen by Virtus.pro. That's going to force LGB. Oh, no, no, no. Conventional wisdom says that LGB should purchase up armor pistol in this round in an attempt to get ahead economically and break the economy of their opponents. However, instead, they are going to full save. Conventional wisdom be damned. Taz watching middle right now. T's streaming forward. There's a bunch of them. Fun little shooting gallery. He finally gets taken down, but a nice pistol shot by Rubino. Definitely the MVP over there for LGB. And looking like T's are going to rotate around and take bomb site B. Two players picked a piece. It is 3v3 once again. These have been such close rounds. Don't worry, those Snacks. Look at that spray control. On the second spray, after that original kill, was able to get a headshot. That's really nice. Zeeves moving into the site. I think he's... Oh, nice shot on Pasha. Puts it into a 1v1. This is definitely a winnable situation. Bialy moves in. Zeeves has one flash on him, and that's it. Interesting smoke position. Put it there at the generator. Gonna disallow the player pushing through generator, which is the standard way to retake this site. Zeeves is a smart player. That smoke is gonna clear, though. Bialy assumes he's inside of it, and he is, hits him, and he somehow is able to survive. Bialy able to take out Zeeves. Zeeves unfortunately messed that up a little bit. Bialy, what are you doing, buddy? Looking for the kit. Oh, did he just screw that up? Oh my goodness. I don't believe it. Bialy with the absolute fail. I could just imagine the comms right there. Now, you're going to have to imagine that I'm speaking Polish, but this is kind of how it went. There's a kit. It's on my body. Generator. Generator. No, back where you were. Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh. That was comms right there. All right. LGB. Buying up. Pasha as a scout. All right, buddy. That was expensive. He spent all his money on that thing. I am not sure why. T's gonna be creeping forward at mid. Getting that mid control. Nade stack. Nice pick up there by Polly. Nade's very effective on rounds against saving players. Well, Pasha's dead. I guess that scout didn't really come into play. And it looks like they want to split A right now. They could really go either way that they want. Oh, Neo sneaks forward at middle. It seems like Jacob actually knows about it. And picks him off. I think he was a little bit visible through that smoke. Just chilling with the mid control. Have not decided where they want to go just yet. We see the little inching of movements to do a B split. That's exactly what's going to happen. And here is Snacks. I don't think he's going to be able to get a kill here. Oh, man. He's got players on all sides. T's move into the site. Should be able to get that bomb down and win this round easy peasy. All right, both the players at mid right now. I think they're looking for weapons to pick up. Bialy finds Pasha's scout. I don't think they're going to... Are they really going to try and save with just a scout? Okay. Taz going to save this P2000 here. I guess he likes the skin. He picked it up off a dead guy. I don't know. All right, Taz, whatevs. Honestly, that makes zero sense to me. And LGB will plant the bomb and escape five men alive. And Virtus.pro will be able to save that very expensive scout buy that Pasha bought. However, they won't get money. Oh, yeah, they will. Never mind. They're good. They did not die. Okay, LGB now at 11-8. Virtus.pro starting to make some questionable decisions. And it's coming back to haunt them right now. They're falling behind against LGB on their map. Alright, kind of a... Oh gosh, look at this buy here. We got a FAMAS, we got a FAMAS, we got a scout. We don't have any nades or flashes. It's just gonna be a rough buy. Just a rough round here for Virtus.pro. Every single round, LGB has been focusing on taking mid control and then working off of it. Taking this position, chilling, knowing that they hold this entire section of the map. Waiting, 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 getting picks, and then finally deciding to strike. And we have a little bit of a Romeo and Juliet love story here on either side of this wall. Those players will probably sit there for the next 30 seconds or so. Bomb is dropped. Standard setup by Virtus.pro. Could not be more standard. I guess if they had a player at the highway right now, it'd be more standard, but... LGB still with that mid-control. Polly gonna be peeking it. Doesn't see anything. T's set up to do an A-split. Looking like they're gonna commence with it here. Flashing in. Taz is gonna take that flash in the face like a man. Nade stack coming in as well. They know it's gonna be happening. Should start to rotate their players. Just rotating one right here. And Rubino moves in for the two frag. It's looking bleak. Oh my goodness. Well, Neil's able to take a kill. And it's a fake out. They're not actually taking A. Rotating all the way over there to bombsite B. It's just Neo left. 1v4. Probably not going to happen. It looks like Rain is running around the map to try to hunt down this final player. They're not going to let him live. All right, Polly going to engage Neo here. Neo has the upper hand in this engagement. What? Polly throws out the imaginary flashbang to try to trick the player, the pistol. How the heck did Polly know that that player was at middle? That was really weird. Neo definitely walked that entire way, and Polly, that was definitely meant, oh, no, wait, was he just picking up a pistol? What kind of sidearm does he have? That's a Glock, so no, never mind. That was supposed to be a fake flash. All right, T's again, very quickly taking mid control. Another save round here from Virtus.pro. They don't really have anything. They have been so hurt economically through some bad economic decisions this entire half so far. And it's looking very bleak for them. They may have gotten overconfident. All right, the smoke going down there. Beautiful smoke. T's take the mid. Here's Taz with a P250. Good position. And we'll be able to pick one of those players. Actually, that is going to be Snacks there, who falls out of the vents. Seeing the player go vents is probably tell you, like, okay, they're going to be a little bit weak at A. And we see Polly hiding an AK-47 to make sure that these CTs cannot pick it up. Seems like they actually want to boost a player back up here to middle. May actually be looking for that AK-47. Because they know it went down. They know Giacomo died there. Alright, here is Rubino. In for the entry frag. Good nade. Nade is going to kill Pasha. Zeeves gets a jumping AK-47 headshot on Bialy, I believe. And two players left trying to rotate in here. Probably not going to happen. Polly with some weak spray control. May actually allow Neo to get the kill here. That would be embarrassing. And his teammate moves in and helps out. Just going to be Snacks left. They should send a player around the other side to hunt him down. That's going to be Zeeves here. Oh, pull out your gun, Zeeves! And Snacks will be able to grab himself an AK-47 and escape. We still have one player left. Polly in hot pursuit coming back to finish what he started. Snacks is just going to try to survive at this point. This is a nice position to do so. And Polly moves into B. He's got a player on both sides. A few seconds left to live. And Snacks will survive. LGB now at 13 points against Virtus.pro's 8. Virtus.pro going to have to play catch up here if they want a chance of winning this. LGB getting closer and closer to victory. Alright, no ops on the field. That is unique. Look at this. No ops. No ops. It seems like LGB has enough money that they could, if they wanted to do a T-side op, why not? Okay. Oh, wow. Zeeves just sprayed down Pasha as he tries to take the standard forward position. They still got Taz in position here, but still, that was devastating. They weren't even able to fire a shot there, and they lose Pasha. Alright, Bialy to try to hold off an A-tank. Nobody really in a position to rotate, so it's all up to him. He's got two flashes. That's not really going to hold off the army. There he goes. Should probably throw the second one right away here. T's getting ready to push. The flash worked! And he picks off a player. CT's rotating now. It's going to be a slow rotate. Lurk player Rubino picks off Neo. And Bialy surprisingly doesn't pull out the pistol. Goes for the... Oh my goodness, Bialy finally goes down. Here is Taz, 1v2, just took out that player, and bomb is down on Taz. Nice little crouch peek there from Jackham. Virtus.pro now at 8 points, LGB at 14. Virtus.pro finally able to win around there. They're still a little bit hurt economically. And LGB so close to victory at 14 points. Snacks is going to be watching middle right now. With this AWP, we finally have an AWP on the field here for Virtus.pro. Nice pickup. Two players at middle, both getting the pick. That's going to make it tough for LGB. We saw this happen a lot on the first half, where two players very quickly got picked, and it just made for a very awkward round. Nah, it's going to be very difficult. Not really much they can do. And oh gosh, Rubino gets shot in the foot by that AWP, or by Snacks, who's up inside of the heaven right now. One player inside of the site, that is Neo, with this FAMAS. He's got players moving in on all sides. He's off Zeeves. That's going to be a trade. Trade is exactly what you want to do in this situation. Rubino 1v2. All right, he's done 1v2s before. This is doable. Rubino picks up the AWP, though. Is that really the weapon you want in a 1v2 scenario? 16 health left. Just a little tap of the fire there would have killed our man Rubino. All right, 1v2. He's got a player at middle right now who could catch him off guard at any time. That's going to be Bialy's. We have Pasha up the side of the site, and Pasha gets the shot off of him as Rubino tries to peek. Virtus.pro now at 9 points, but again, they're going to have to play an incredible catch-up here if they want to win this thing. They pretty much have to win out every single round if they don't want it to go into overtime. Tall order for Virtus.pro, but if they keep getting picks like that early on, they have a chance. Looking like Snacks is going to go for that forward B off position. Lots of mid players there for Virtus.pro. I think the right call is to chill. Nice pick by Rain. This makes it doable. Another pick up. There's the two pick. Rain kills both of them. Now could just be a 15 point here for LGB. Easy peasy lemon squeezy pickup. 5 versus 3. CT's going to have to spread themselves pretty thin. Wow, Snacks takes out Rain. Finally, Rain is dead. T set up to take bomb site A. We have Bialy in a forward position. And we have Snacks back here with the op-ed truck. LGB not making up their mind, playing it a little bit more passive now. We still have Neo over there at bomb site B, though. Bialy in a forward position. LGB needs to be a little bit more assertive here on their takes. Timer dwindling down. They know Virtus.pro has to spread themselves weak. Has to spread themselves thin. And moving into the site, they should have one player and one retake to deal with quickly. I don't know what they're waiting for. Now deciding to push. Giving advanced warning will allow the player to rotate. Now Bialy picks up Rubino. They've rotated back to middle. It's going to be a fake. But Neo has already started to rotate. That is a nice smoke. It's going to prevent them from taking B. They were going to try and fake A and take B. 17 seconds left. It's not enough time. Playing a little ring around the rosy game here. And Bialy picks up the final two players. Actually, that's Snacks who kills the other one. And Virtus.pro outsmarts LGB big time. Seems like LGB is just so close to victory here. They are starting to fall apart. They're starting to choke. That looked like an easy win. All they had to do was just push into A. That's it. Push in. Take it. Smoke off here, whatever you want to do, guys, you got it. Instead, they tried to be fancy. They tried to push in here, throw some flashes over, rotate all the way back and take B. Not gonna happen. Virtus.pro is on top of that. You gotta think, like, they got three players. Where are they gonna put them? One A, one middle, one B. B player could be pushed up close or pushed further back in order to rotate quickly. All right, LGB. They got the bomb. Creeping around the map. We got Taz in the forward position. Getting intel. Smoke down at middle. They're going to boost up Rain. Rain got two picks here before. Snacks is watching that like a hawk right now. This is going to be a difficult place to peek. Not going to happen. T's rotating around. Look like they want to take bomb site B. For the most part, they've always split. So they've always done or come in from two spots. And to come in from two spots at B, you have to take mid. So I think they're going to try for some mid-control here. Oh, Taz in a good position right now. No, they're actually not. They're just pushing right into the site. Good pickups. There's two picks again. This could be the round that they need. Interesting position from Snacks. A perfect smoke will disallow him from pushing in. 3 versus 4 of the retake. It's difficult, but it's possible. Taz takes some damage on that Molotov right now. Snacks tries to push in. Looking like we could have a 15-pointer here for LGB against Virtus.pro. In this best of one. And yeah, looks like Virtus.pro is going to try and save it. They're going to have to play for an overtime. And LGB, finally able to just push into the site and just take it, wins the round. They've got one more round to win, though, if they want a victory. All right. Bialy and Taz. Let's check out the money there on Virtus.pro. I think they're going to have some trouble next round. Oh yeah, they're going to have to force buy up. It looks bleak for Virtus.pro. What can they get? Armor pistol. No smokes or flashes. Oh no, they've got, what, 4 flashes total and 2 smokes? Well, they got 3 smokes. Snacks forced to use a deagle. This is going to be a tough round. LGB at victory's doorstep. All they got to do is knock and enter. Bomb is dropped, creeping around the map. They're playing it super safe right now. Rubino watching the boost spot up there in case anything happens. Nothing is going to happen, though. And they're creeping around. Got that bomb. Notice the movements back from A, making it look like they want to take mid-control right now. Actually got those two players at A main. Here's Bialy watching that. And, oh gosh, Bialy just got picked by Rain. Looking like LGB is going to take it. This is match point. They've done this before. They've usually faked in these positions. They take the pick at A, and then they've rotated to B. Look how smart Virtus.pro has positioned their players at B, anticipating this movement from LGB. Will it be enough, though? They have definitely anticipated this movement. They've stacked the bomb site with three players. Actually, that's two players. There's a decoy in there. Never mind. Caster got fooled by decoy. Here we are. Match point. T's trying to push into the site. Good pickup by Neo. Going for the next one. Snacks kills two players. Three players with a deagle. My goodness, and Virtus.pro holds onto it. We have to get an owl vision on those deagle kills. Who said the deagle was out of style? Not Freiburg and not Snacks. LGB. Poised to win it now. Match point. Oh, look at this. They're aggressively buying. They have a few rounds to spare. I'm surprised they didn't go for the eco here. Two players with Tech 9s doing an aggressive buy. This is a very common buy that we see. Three players buy and two players armor pistol. The economy works out in a way where players tend to buy in these situations. Bialy in a forward position. Rain again gets the entry frag off of Bialy. Rain is consistently getting that. There's the smoke down in middle. All right, T's taking middle. Now falling back. They're just like, they're leaving middle? That's going to be a yes. Jack Helm. Sitting up inside of the vents right now. T's rotating around, looking like they want to split B. They got players all across the map right now. They got the pick. Again, being very Navi-esque in their movements, waiting to take the bomb sites, letting the time dwindle. Rain tries to push into A, okay. And again, same setup. Fake an A, take a B. Here they come, let's see if they can win it. Good pickups, gonna be a 2-4 retake right now on this match point. Going to be a very difficult retake. Here's Zeeves watching over, takes out Pasha. Just one player left, it's gonna be Taz. 1-4 for the retake. Probably not gonna happen as he creeps into the vents right here. Picks off Rubino, moves into the site, and gets taken down immediately by Jacob. Thank you folks very much for watching. That is going to be a win for LGB over Virtus.pro. It cannot be understated how significant of a win that was. It was a best of one, but again, very nice job by that team beating Virtus.pro on their own map. Thank you folks very much for watching. I am the War Owl, and I still have no closer. Bicep's always with you, my friend.